class 8 maths. Exercise 2B. We are revising this exercise. So far as question 1 is concerned, it says write in standard form. It's the fifth part of question 1, 463, and followed by 10 zeros. In a standard form, students, it will be written as 4.63 to 10 to the power how much as you are coming towards left. From here, 10 zeros, 11 and 12 places, therefore 10 to the power 12. Understood? We are coming 12 places towards left. Therefore, it is 10 to the power. Question 2 is write in usual form 5.17 into 10 to the power 6. This 6 throws this decimal 6 places towards right, so it becomes 5.7 followed by 4 zeros. Now, here in question 5, it says write in standard form. It is a bigger number, it is a very small number. So here decimal goes is 5.6 places towards right, therefore 1.65 into 10 power minus 6. And in question 7, it is 5 in usual form, 1.8 into 10 power minus 2 or any power can be here. Connect decimal goes 2 places towards left and becomes 0.01. In this way, students, this is all about this exercise 2B. Nothing more is here. So try to understand. Now, try to do other question of this exercise. And exercise 2C, which is multiple choice exercise. And if any doubt arises, you ask it. After that, we shall do here we shall revise X chapter 3, exercise 3A. Here in question 1 and in question 2, you have to say which numbers are perfect square. So here the in first case it is given using prime factorization, and in second case, so that each any way, either by factorization or by division method, you have to show that numbers are perfect square numbers. So, exercise 3A, I am doing any one part of question 1, students, because you know this. So, prime factorization is needed. Here I am taking 6th part of question 1. 6th part of question 1, exercise 3A. We are writing 6th part of question 1, students. And that is 9075. It says by factorization find whether it is a perfect square or not. So you can do it in this way. 5 is here, so we start with 5. 1 8 1 5. Then by 5 it becomes 5 3 50. Here 5 6 5 50. Then by 3 it comes 1 2 1. Then by 11 it comes this one. So it is 5 square into 11 square into 3. And students, here 3 has no pair, so it is not a perfect square. It's very simple, students. And in other numbers, you will find some paired prime factors. So they will be perfect square. As question is, it's question 1089. It is 3 × 3 × 11 × 11. Because 3 is in pair, 11 is in pair, therefore it will be a perfect square. Now in second, so that each of the following number is a perfect square, means just find number whose square is the given number. Means you have to find out the square root also, and you have to show that numbers are perfect squares. You may use factorization. I am doing fourth part of this question 2 7056 here. Question 2 is fourth part is 7056. Here students, 7056, it is divided by 2 and 4, but I am not doing that. 7 × 5 = 12 and 6 = 18, it is multiple of 3 also. So let me start with 3. 3 × 2 = 8, 3 × 5 = 21. Then sum is not divided by 3, so 2 is 3, 9 and 2. Then again by 2, it is 1, 9 and 6. Again by 2, 2, 9 and 8. Again by 2, it is 49 and 7 and 7. So students, it is 3² × 2² × 2² × 7². As prime factors are paired in the factors, 3² × 2² × 2² × 7² are in pairs, so it is a perfect square. Likewise, you can do any one of number 2 of exercise 3 is 2. Now, by what least number should the given number be multiplied or divided? In case here, it should be multiplied by the prime factors which have no pair, or factors which have no pairs, and here division should also be divided by the same number. So, I am doing up. Question 3 and question 4 students. So question 3, part I am taking any part. Question 3, I am taking a bigger number 7623 and 6th part. 7, 6, 2, 3. It says by what number it should be multiplied to make it a perfect square. So let us see what are prime factors. 7, 6, 2, 3 is here student. 7, 6, 13 and 5, 13. So 3, 3, 2, 5, 4, 1. Again by 3, because 3 is 24, 3, 4, 7. Again by 3, so it is not divided by 2 also, So we are going up, it is not divisible by 5 because 0 and 5 are not at unit place. So here, if we have a 7, it is multiple of 7. So 7, 1 ja 7, 2 ja and 1, and it is 11 in the left. So see students, it is 3 square into 11 square into 7. Here 7 is allowed. Students, in this case, in the prime factorization of 7, 6, 2, 3, you see 7 is allowed. So if this number is multiplied by 7, here 7 has not there. Therefore, it must be multiplied by 7 to make it a perfect square, and square root, the required square root will be 3 into 11 into 7. That comes because 1 will be 3, other will be 11, and after multiplication there will be 2 7, so 1 7, it is 77 into 3, 3 7 is 21, and 3 7 is 21, and 2 23. So 231 is the square root. It is this part, I think, 6th part of question 3. Yes, 6th part. In this way. Similarly, in question 4, what number it should be divided here in question 3, 6th part. If question by what number it should be divided, then answer will be it should be divided by 7, and then square root will be 3 into 11, that is 33. Similarly, let us do one sum simply, and we are taking here 7776, which is 6th quad. 6th quad of small question. It is 7, 7, 7, and 6. So students, 7, 7, 7, 6. Here 3, 21, and 6 is 27. It is multiple of 3. 2 here is also there. What is called with 3? 3 2 year, 3 5 year, 9 year, and 2 year. Again by 3, then it is 3 8 year, 24, 3 6 year, 3 4. Here, then again, 3, 3 2 year, 6, 2 6, 8 year, and 8. Again by 3, so 3, 9 year, 27 and 6 year. Again by 3, it gives 32. Now 32 has 5 2s, 16, 2, 8, 2, 4, 2, 2. So it has 3, 5 and 3 2s. It is 3 square into 3 square into 2 square into 2 square into 3 into 2. The students, here 1 3 and 1 2 has no pair. Therefore, it should be divided by 3 into 2, 6 to make it a perfect square. Here you will write, here 3 and 2 has no pair. Therefore, it must be divided by 3 into 2, that is 6, to make it a perfect square. And required square root here, required square root will be 3 into 2. And
that is 6. When 3 into 3 into 2, sorry, 3 into 3 into 2 into 2, that is 9 over 36. After dividing by 6, it becomes 1, 2, 9 and 6. And then, students, its square root will be 36. Because it should be divided, you will write here, therefore it is here, 3 and 2 has not there, therefore it must be divided by 3 into 2, that is 6, to make it a right square. When 7, 7, 7, 6 is divided by 3 and 2, then factors will be 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 4 times and 4 times 2, which will be 3 square, 3 square, 2 square, 2 square, whose root will be 3 into 3 into 2 into 2, that is 36 students. So thus we are here, we discussed 4 questions of exercise 3A, and now find largest number of 2D which is a perfect square. Largest number of 2D students. This question is a old question because and in second case, largest number of 3 digits is required. So in 2 digits, you know 100, which is a 3-digit number, the least 3-digit number is a square of 10. So largest square number will be 81, which is 9 square. And in case of 3 digits number, its limit is 999. That is 999, and you know after that it comes 1 followed by 4 zeros whose square root is 100. Therefore, largest number of 3 digits which will perfect square will be 99 square. In first case 9 square and in second case 99 square. So students, 99 square you do and you will get the number which is largest of 3 digits. 99 into 99, here 9 and 81 9 and 81 and 8 89, again here 1 9 and 8, so that number is 0 1, here 0 9 8 17 1 18 9 8 0. Largest number of 3-digit number, largest 3-digit number. So I discussed largest number of 3-digit is 9999, and it's 1000 is more than, sorry, sorry students, here in first case for 2D81, for 3 digits number largest is 999, and number greater than this number is 1000, which is not a perfect square. And after 1000 students, this is 1024, which is a perfect square, and that is a square of 32. It has exactly 10 2's multiplied by root 2. So 31 square will be the largest number, and 31 square is 31 into 31. 31 into 1 is 31, 3. 31, 3 is 93 and 3 is 96. So 961 is the largest number, because below this 999, which is a perfect square, it is number 6. Thus we have finished exercise 3A students, and let us stop our video because it is about 20 minutes.